Okay, good morning students. Welcome to the GST and Customs Act class. Now we are at the end of the syllabus of GST and Customs Act subject. In the fifth unit, all theoretical topics have been completed, and from today onwards we are going to solve some of the problems relating to the valuation of goods under Customs Act. What is the procedure? Or what is the methodology adapted for valuation of goods so as to levy and collect various customs duties as per the Customs Act? So I request all of you to note down these problems. You will get problems in the fifth unit, even in the examinations also. Therefore, these are small problems, just pro forma wise, how to calculate the FOB value and CIF value and assessable value so as to calculate the customs duties, various customs duties. Okay, these are part of fifth unit. So in this regard, in the previous classes we have learned that the goods imported, whatever the goods or services imported from outside India, on those goods and services, the customs officers in the port, navy port, they receive the goods, or the goods will be under their custody, and they value the, they assess the value of the goods and the services, and they are going to levy various customs duties as per the Customs Act. So what are the various things that are considered for valuation of the goods and services? What is the procedure? You know, this is the procedure where the assessment of value of the goods and services that are imported from outside India. Now, calculation of assessable value. There is a pro forma. This is the pro forma. Please, all of you, note down. Heading: calculation of assessable value. Calculation of assessable value. Particulars, rupees. Particulars, rupees. Here, in the amount column, it may be rupees or it may be US dollars or some other currency. So whatever the currency is given, that currency value we have to enter in the amount column. Two columns, table, particulars, rupees. This is the pro forma. how the various items appear in the calculation of the assessable value of the goods. The particulars rupees. So in the first, value of material within brackets at X factory price. At X factory price. So that is the first item we have to show. So that means what is the value of material at the factory level? What is the value of material at the factory gate? Factory gate means the exporter's factory gate or exporter's point. So that value of material is to be entered here. From that value of material, add carriage freight or insurance up to the port within brackets C or A of shipment in the exporter's country. That means we have to add all the expenses incurred by the exporter to bring the goods from his factory to the shipping area or the shipment area of the exporter's country. So all loading charges, carriage charges, freight charges, if we do insurance, all these expenses. That means to bring goods from the factory of exporter, to the shipping company or to the ship port, up to ship port, whatever the expenses incurred by the exporter, all those expenses are to be added to the value of material. Okay, so carriage, freight or insurance up to the port, either C or A. C means shipment port, A means aeroplane. Sometimes the goods may be transported by aeroplane. So up to shipping yard or airport, all the expenses are to be added. C or A of shipment in the exporter's country, up to the shipping area or airport area of the exporter's country, all those expenses are to be added. Next, for that, add charges. Add charges for the loading onto the ship at the shipping port in the exporter's country. Next, adding is the various charges or various expenses for the loading onto the ship at the shipping port in the exporter's country. That means the freight agency or the transportation agency will bring goods from factory of the exporter to the shipping company or shipping port. In the shipping port, again, the goods are to be loaded into the ship. Goods are to be loaded into the ship. So, for that, the exporter will pay some expenses. So, all those charges are also to be added to the above value. That is, charges for the loading on to the ship at the shipping port in the exporter's country. That amount also you have to add to the. So, the total of these three, that is value of material plus carriage, freight or insurance up to the port of shipment in the exporter's country plus charges. Hello? Hello, who is on the line? Hello? Vinipistundi na voice nana? Can anybody respond?
Yes, sir.
Vinipistundi kada?
Vinipistundi, sir.
Raskuntunnara?
Yes, sir.
రాసుకోండినా ఈ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్లో కూడా వస్తాయి. ఎగ్జామినేషన్లో సింపుల్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ అంతే. ఎట్లా వాల్యుయేషన్ చేస్తారు కస్టమ్స్ డ్యూటీలో, ఏ ఏ ఖర్చులు ఎట్లా కలపాలి అనేది సింపుల్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్. ఓకే, సో ద టోటల్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ త్రీ, వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ మెటీరియల్ ప్లస్ క్యారేజ్ ఆర్ ఫ్రైట్ ఆర్ ఇన్సూరెన్స్ అప్ టు ది పోర్ట్ ఆఫ్ షిప్మెంట్ ఇన్ ద ఎక్స్పోర్టర్స్ కంట్రీ ప్లస్ charges for the loading onto the ship at the shipment port in the exporter's country. So the total of these three is known as So total of these three elements is
Dr. V. Sivaprasad, English.
FOB value. The total of value of material and these two expenses is free on board value. Free on board value, that is FOB value. So FOB value means it is the total of the price of material plus transportation charges up to the ship area and loading charges of the exporter's ship area. These three are clubbed together. You will get free on board value, FOB value. So on FOB value, the exporter is expected to pay customs duty in their country. The exporters are expected to pay customs duties in their country. This FOB value on imports is calculated in this manner. Next, after FOB value, suppose if any of these expenses have been incurred, those are also to be added to the FOB value. Let's add, if not included in the above. Suppose if any of these items are not included in the above, then commission and brokerage. But the commission, except buying commission, if the importer has paid any buying commission, that commission should not be added. Except buying commission, other commissions and brokerage charges may be added to the free on board value. That's it, commission and brokerage. Next, add packing cost. So for the purpose of packing the goods, packing cost is to be added. So in this packing cost also, except cost of durable and returnable packing. That means if any expenses incurred for durable packing or returnable packing, that should not be added. Only the temporary packing charges or temporary expenses expenses incurred to pack the goods temporarily in the temporary package, those expenses are to be added to that value. That's packing cost. Next, cost of engineering, development and plan or sketches. Nana evunaina mute cheskondi, audio on chesaru, mute cheskondi. So cost of engineering, development and plan or sketches that is undertaken outside India. That means if any cost of engineering and development and plan or sketches undertaken outside India, though all those expenses can also, may also be added to this value. So next, royalties and license fees. If they have paid any royalty fees or license fees, that are also to be added to the above value. Okay, next, value of subsequent resale. Then Babu, evaro unmute chesaru chudu, mute cheskondi. Evaro unmute chesindi? Hello, mute cheskonena. Hey Babu, evaro Sangatti? ఎవరినైనా సంగటి ఎంతరో అంతేరు మ్యూట్ చేసుకోమని అన్న మ్యూట్ చేసుకోమని చెప్పండి ఇది
ఆనంద్
అని పేరు
అవును సార్
ఏ ఆనంద్ మ్యూట్ చేసుకోనైనా ఏ ఆనంద్ आनंद म्यूट चेसुको सो नेक्स्ट वैल्यू ऑफ सब्सिक्वेंट रीसेल इफ पेएबल टू फॉरेन सप्लायर दैट वैल्यू आल्सो इज टू बी एडेड द वैल्यू ऑफ सब्सिक्वेंट रीसेल इफ पेएबल टू फॉरेन सप्लायर दैट मींस इफ यू हैव पेड एनी value that can be resold again that value also you have to add to this particular value next value of material supplied by the buyer free of cost that means suppose if the importer has paid any expenses or value of material at free of cost to the exporter that value of material should also be added to that particular figure okay so value of material supplied by the buyer means importer is a buyer free of cost If you have supplied any material at free of cost, that value also is to be added. So, if you add all these things, the FOB value as per customs will be arrived. So, the total of all these things, that means FOB value plus all these expenses. FOB value is decided based on the value of material plus carriage or transport. Expenses incurred for bringing goods to the port and loading charges. So these three are FOB value. Suppose in that FOB value, if any expenditure of the below mentioned is not added, they may be added to this FOB value. That is commission and brokerage, except buying commission, packing cost. Except cost of durable and returnable packing, cost of engineering, development and plan or sketch undertaken outside India. Okay. Next, royalties and license fees. The expenses incurred for royalties and license fees that is to be added. Next, value of subsequent resale. If payable to foreign supplier, so that is also to be added. Next, value of material supplied by the buyer free of cost, that is also to be added. So, if you add all these things, all these expenses along with the value of material, then the FOB value as per customs will be arrived. So, on this value. The exporter will pay customs duties in his country because these taxes are not applicable to the importer. Suppose if you have agreed to buy goods on CIF value, there are two types of values. That can be purchased by the importer, FOB value or CIF value. If the importer is agreed to buy at CIF value, CIF value means cost, insurance and freight value, then every expenditure will be borne by the exporter. The importer need not pay anything except import duties and all these things. All these expenses are to be borne by the exporter only. That means CIF price or CIF value means the responsibility of the importer. The responsibility of the importer starts only after arrival of goods in the importer's country. Goods in the shipping port of the importer's country up to bringing goods to ship in importer's shipping area. All expenses will be borne by the exporter only. Suppose if the importer agreed to buy on FOB value, if the importer is agreed to buy import FOB value, then after reaching the goods to the exporter's shipment area, then onwards all expenses are to be borne by the importer only. Okay, so this is the FOB value as per customs. If you add all these things, you will get FOB value as per customs. Okay, next, after that, the following expenses will be added to the FOB value so as to calculate the CIF value. For the purpose of calculating the CIF value, cost, insurance and freight value, the following expenses are to be added. What are those? Cost of freight, if not specified, at the rate of 20% of FOB value as per customs. The cost of freight, that means the cost of freight, cost of transportation, if not specified, at the rate of 20% of FOB value as per customs officers. Cost of freight, if not specified, at 20% of FOB value per customs. That means whatever the transportation.
అప్డేట్ చేయవలసిందిగా ప్రిన్సిపల్ గారు తెలియజేస్తున్నారు. ఎవరైతే సెకండ్ సెమ్ క్లాసులు తీసుకుంటున్నారో ఆన్లైన్ లో వాళ్ళందరూ వాళ్ళ యొక్క క్రైటీరియాను అప్రూవ్ చేయవలసిందిగా ప్రిన్సిపల్ గారు తెలియజేస్తున్నారు.
సో కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్రైట్ అంటే ఇది మనకు ఇంపోర్టర్ ద ఎక్స్పెన్సెస్ ఇన్కర్డ్ బై ది ఇంపోర్టర్ విల్ స్టార్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ హియర్ కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్రైట్. So maximum 20%, subject to maximum 20% of FOB value as per customs. Next, ship demurrage charges on chartered vessels. So this is also another expenses that can be allowed for calculation of CIF value. That is ship demurrage charges on chartered vessel, that expenses also is to be added. Next, lighterage or barge charges. If we have paid any of these expenses, that also to be added. Next, insurance expenses are also to be added. Suppose if the insurance expenses are not specified, or suppose if anybody has not made insurance for the goods, then the customs officers will charge at the rate of 1.125% of the FOB value as per customs. That means, if they have not mentioned the insurance expenses, the customs officers will add at the rate of 1.125% of the FOB value as per customs. Okay, so that is another expenses to be added. So if you add all these things to the FOB value, that means FOB value as per customs plus cost of freight, ship demurrage charges, lighterage or barge charges, insurance charges. If you add all these things, you will get the cost, insurance and freight value. CIF value. That is cost, insurance, and freight value. Or this is also known as assessable value. This may be also known as assessable value. Okay, so in this way, the CIF value or assessable value will be calculated by the customs officers. The importer who is importing goods from outside India, the importers are expected to pay customs duties on this assessable value or on this cost, insurance, and freight value or CIF value. Okay, so the CIF value or assessable value, sometimes there may be some adjustments for CIF value. So along with CIF value, 1% of other charges may be added based on the situation by the customs officer. But on the whole, the assessable value and CIF value is the FOB value as per customs plus cost of freight, cost of ship demurrage charges, lightering or barge charges, plus insurance. So all these add together, you will get the CIF value or assessable value. This is how you have to calculate the assessable value. That means in the examination, you will be given different expenses incurred by the exporter and incurred by the importer. So according to this pro forma, you have to calculate the assessable value. You have to calculate the assessable value of the goods. So once again, I will read out the pro forma. Particulars, rupees. Value of material at X factory price. So for that, you have to add various expenses incurred by the exporter. That is, add carriage, freight, or insurance up to the port. That is, either sea or air of shipment in the exporter's country. Next, add charges for the loading onto the ship at the shipping port in the exporter's country. So if you add these three, you will get free on board value. So for this free on board value, again some expenses, if any of the following expenses are not included in the above category of expenses, they may also be added by the customs officers. What are those? Add, if not included in the above, commission and brokerage. Commission and brokerage is to be added. But in the commission, buying commission should not be added. The commission paid for buying or importing goods from that country to this country, that commission should not be added. Okay. Next, packing cost. Packing cost also is to be added. But in the packing cost also, durable and returnable packing expenses should not be added. Except cost of durable and returnable packing. Other packing costs may be added. Next, cost of engineering, development, and plan or sketches. Undertaken outside India. So that means for this purpose, that means for importing goods from outside India to India, if any engineering services have been hired or any plan or any sketch has been prepared, so all those expenses are also to be added to this particular thing. Next, in the same manner, royalties and the license fees. If you have paid any royalty fees or license fees, that are also to be added to the above value. Next, value of subsequent resale. Value of subsequent resale, if payable to foreign supplier. Value of subsequent resale, if payable to foreign supplier, that is also to be added. Next, value of material supplied by the buyer free of cost. Value of material supplied by the buyer free of cost. That means if the importer has supplied any material at free of cost to the exporter, that value also is to be added for customs. So if you add all these things, you will get the FOB value as per customs. This is the value of FOB as per customs. So on this FOB value, the customs officers of exporting country, will levy customs duties in exporting country. Next, from for that value, for export FOB value as per customs, we have to add the other expenses. That means after reaching the goods in the shipping boat, then whatever the expenses incurred by the importer, all the expenses are to be added to the FOB value as per customs. So among these, cost of freight of the importer, if not specified, at the rate of 20% of FOB value as per customs. So if he has not mentioned anything about the cost of freight, the customs officers will charge at the rate of 20% on FOB value as per customs. Next, ship demurrage charges on chartered vessels. This is charges levied by the shipyard people or shipping company. So that expenses are also added to the FOB value. Next, lighterage or barge charges are also to be added. Next, insurance. The expenses incurred for getting insurance to the goods that are transported. Suppose if nothing is mentioned about the insurance, the customs officers will charge at the rate of 1.125% of FOB value as per customs. If the importer has not mentioned anything about the insurance, then the customs officers will add 1.125% of the FOB value of customs as per customs. That value will be added by the customs officers. Okay, next. So if you add all these things, all these expenses to the FOB value, then you will get the cost, insurance and freight value or assessable value. Cost, insurance and freight value or assessable value. So this is the value on which the importer's customs officers in the importer's country will levy customs duties. మన భారతదేశంలో ఉండేటువంటి కస్టమ్స్ అధికారులు ఈ సిఐఎఫ్ వాల్యూ మీద లేదా అసెసబుల్ వాల్యూ మీద వాళ్ళు కస్టమ్స్ డ్యూటీస్ ఛార్జ్ చేస్తారు. ఓకే, ఇక్కడ ఇచ్చినటువంటి ఎఫ్ఓబి ఈ కస్టమ్స్ ఎఫ్ఓబి వాల్యూ మీద ఎగుమతి చేసేటువంటి దేశంలో ఉండేటువంటి కస్టమ్స్ అధికారులు దాని మీద ఎగుమతిదారునికి కస్టమ్స్ సుంకాలు విధిస్తారు. FOB value as per customs. దీని మీద ఏమో ఎగుమతి చేసే దేశంలో ఉండేటువంటి కస్టమ్స్ అధికారులు సుంకాలు వసూలు చేస్తారు. సిఐఎఫ్ వాల్యూ మీదనేమో దిగుమతి చేసుకునేటువంటి దేశంలో ఉండేటువంటి కస్టమ్స్ అధికారులు సుంకం చెల్లిస్తారు, సుంకం విధించి వసూలు చేస్తారు. కాబట్టి ఇప్పుడు మనకు ప్రాబ్లమ్స్లో రకరకాల ఎక్స్పెన్సెస్ ఇస్తారు, వాటిని బేస్ చేసుకొని మనము ఈ ఫస్ట్ కేటగిరీలో ఏమేమి యాడ్ చేయాలి. ఓకే, అంటే ఎఫ్ఓబి వాల్యూ కనుగొనడానికి ఏ ఏ ఖర్చులు కలపాలి, నెక్స్ట్ ఎఫ్ఓబి వాల్యూ కనుగొన్న తర్వాత నెక్స్ట్ ఏమేమి ఖర్చులు కలపాలి, అవన్నీ కలిపి మనం సిఐఎఫ్ వాల్యూ లేదా అసెసబుల్ వాల్యూ అనేది క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేయాల్సి ఉంటుంది. ఓకే, సో ఇది ప్రొఫార్మా. ఈ ప్రొఫార్మా నోట్ చేసుకొని కొద్దిగా చదువుకోండి. అందరు నోట్ చేసుకున్నారు కదా, దీన్ని కొద్దిగా చదువుకోండి. చదువుకుంటే మనకు రేపు ప్రాబ్లం చేసేటప్పుడు ఏ ఏ ఖర్చులు ఎక్కడ వస్తాయి దాన్ని బట్టి ఊరికి జస్ట్ అడిషన్ యాడ్ చేసుకుంటూ వాల్యూ పోవడం అనమాట. ఓకే, సో నెక్స్ట్ క్లాస్లో మనం ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ స్టార్ట్ చేద్దాము. ఒక 4-5 ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ చేస్తే మీకు కూడా ఒక అవగాహన వస్తుంది. ఎందుకంటే ఎగ్జామినేషన్లో మనకు ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ కూడా సిలబస్లో ఇచ్చారు కాబట్టి ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ అని. సో మనకి ఎగ్జామినేషన్లో కూడా ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ రావచ్చు. ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ అయితే ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఇవ్వలేదు, కానీ మనం చెప్పలేము, ఎగ్జామినర్ను బట్టి ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ మెన్షన్ చేశారు కాబట్టి సిలబస్లో ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఇవ్వచ్చు. సింపుల్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ అంతే, ఊరికే ఖర్చులన్నీ యాడ్ చేసుకుంటూ ఎక్స్పోర్టర్ పెట్టిన ఖర్చులన్నీ యాడ్ చేస్తే మనకు మెటీరియల్కు ఎక్స్పోర్టర్ పెట్టిన ఖర్చులన్నీ యాడ్ చేస్తే ఎఫ్ఓబి వాల్యూ వస్తుంది, దానికి ఇంపోర్టర్ పెట్టిన ఖర్చులన్నీ యాడ్ చేస్తే సిఐఎఫ్ వాల్యూ వస్తుంది. సింపుల్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్, మనం టుమారో అన్వర్డ్స్ విల్ సాల్వ్ ది ప్రాబ్లమ్స్. ఓకే, థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ ఫర్ జాయినింగ్ ఇన్ ద క్లాస్. అండ్ నెంబర్ పోస్ట్ చేసిన వాళ్ళు ఎగ్జిట్ అయిపోండి. ఓకే, థ్యాంక్ యూ.
థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్.
ఆల్రెడీ పోస్ట్ చేసిన వాళ్ళు మళ్ళీ పోస్ట్ చేయాల్సిన అవసరం లేదు, నేను నెంబరు ఒకసారి